उत्तर प्रदेश को भारतीय जनता पार्टी के और आदित्यनाथ जी के कुशासन से मुक्त कराने के लिए एक कॉमन एजेंडा पे समान मुद्दों पर एक रणनीतिक और राजनीतिक चर्चा हुई है।
अभी हम लोग की चर्चा सपा कार्यालय में राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष अखिलेश सिंह के साथ हुई है और हम लोग का गठबंधन हो गया।
हम उस घर में जाएंगे तब फिर हम आपके विषय में बात करेंगे। तो फिर हम लोगों ने प्रेमचंद प्रजापति की पार्टी, बाबूराम पाल की पार्टी, अनिल चौहान की पार्टी, रामसागर बिंद की पार्टी, हम इन लोगों को लेकर के वहाँ समझौते की घोषणा 27 अक्टूबर को करा दिए।
अगर ओवैसी 5-10 सीटों को लड़ने को तैयार हो तो आप उनको अकोमोडेट करने को
बिल्कुल नहीं, तो एकदम कट सकते हैं, हम तो सबसे कह रहे हैं।
Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. The political temperature is rising in battleground Uttar Pradesh as the strategies to clinch power in the coveted state are taking shape. The BJP eyes another term to hold on to the most populous state of the country, which decides the road to 2024. But the Samajwadi Party is making the big pitch to tackle the saffron juggernaut by cobbling up a Mahagathbandhan of smaller parties. Samajwadi Party has sealed an alliance with Jayant Chaudhary's RLD with an eye on the prominent Jat belt in Western UP. Akhilesh Yadav held a meeting with Aam Aadmi Party's Sanjay Singh in a bid to gain the party's clout in urban pockets and is also wooing MIM chief Asaduddin Owaisi to consolidate its hold on Muslim votes. The Samajwadi Party has also crafted an alliance with Om Prakash Rajbhar's SPSB to rally its clout in the politically prominent Rajbhar community as well as the Apna Dal's Krishna faction, which holds sway over Kurmi votes. Uttar Pradesh is a vast tapestry of caste dynamics, and the Samajwadi Party aims to cobble up pockets to tackle the BJP's Vikas and Kamandal brand of politics. The 2017 experiment with the Congress failed to keep Akhilesh in power and led to the saffron sweep and rise of Yogi Adityanath. In 2019, the alliance with the BSP and the RLD failed to stop the Modi juggernaut, which repeated its saffron sweep of 2014. Can Akhilesh Yadav then end the jinx this time around and craft a winning alliance to tackle the might of the BJP? Joining me on the show, Anila Singh is the spokesperson of the BJP, Pankhuri Pathak representing the Congress, Saad Sherwani, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. Advocate Adil Hassan is youth president of MIM, Sanjay Kumar, Professor CSDS. Sanjay Kumar, going to begin with you. I'm looking at the vote share of all these parties that Akhilesh Yadav is hoping to form an alliance with this time around. RLD 2%, SBSP is 0.70%, MIM is 0.24%, and Aam Aadmi Party did not even contest. What do you think this motley group or a Mahagathbandhan of this nature, minus the Congress, minus the BSP, will be able to achieve?
No, Maya, I think this is a very important step taken by Samajwadi Party. Because in my opinion, if Samajwadi Party has tried to form an alliance with, you know, taking BSP and Congress together, there were chances of a counter-polarization, because people who are opposed to these parties would have consolidated behind BJP. And that would not have been very, very helpful for Samajwadi Party. But the way Samajwadi Party has formed the alliance with smaller parties, leave aside their vote percentages, Aam Aadmi Party has not even contested. Even if we assume that, you know, Aam Aadmi Party is sitting with 1 or 2% vote, leave aside these small percentages of vote which is going to be added to Samajwadi Party, but the perception is getting created. These small groups will consolidate the various support base of these smaller parties. So I think this is turning into a formidable alliance. And these, remember, these smaller parties have pockets of influence. And when I say pockets of influence, this relates to geographical pockets of influence and also among different caste communities. And these are the caste communities which have not voted for Samajwadi Party in a big way in the past election. So Samajwadi Party, this Gathbandhan is becoming stronger and stronger. And the parties which you have named, if Samajwadi Party is able to form an alliance with all these parties, I think this is going to be a very formidable alliance.
Okay, why are you calling it formidable is something I'm going to come back to you and ask that question, Sanjay Kumar. Let me bring in the politicians on the panel. Saad Sherwani, on one hand, you accuse MIM of being the team of the BJP, and then your alliance partner Om Prakash Rajbhar says that they are open to allying with him. Now, whose B team is Mr. Owaisi?
Maria, whatever statements Om Prakash ji is making is based on his conversations with other parties, is his personal view. It has always been the view of the Samajwadi Party to take all those parties along with it that are of a similar mindset. Now, before I go into any depth, I just want to make a few things clear. In 2013, when the Bharatiya Janata Party decided that Modi ji should be their face for the upcoming 2014 elections, there are many elections, state elections that have taken place since then. 2013, there was Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, then the next year there was Maharashtra, there was Haryana, Jharkhand, then followed by Bihar and UP. And in all of these states, the BJP managed to get a very strong mandate based on a number of false promises, based on the promises of Achhe Din. And similar to the result in UP, the results in all of these states were similar. They managed to get a clear mandate and they managed to win all of these elections.
But so is Akhilesh Yadav then open to the idea of allying with Mr. Owaisi? And is Mr. Owaisi really a factor in these elections in UP?
That is a decision that Mr. Owaisi.
So for the moment, you're not ruling a possibility of such an alliance?
I'm sure.
Perhaps even the Samajwadi Party is realizing that perhaps Mr. Owaisi could repeat what happened in Bihar only recently. Come in on this, Anila Singh.
Maria, that is something that I cannot comment on.
Okay, you're not able to comment, but as a political journalist, I'm going to read your silence as being open to the idea. That is what Mr. Rajbhar has also indicated.
I would not say I'm open to the idea at all.
My question here is, look at what is happening within the Apna Dal. Somebody like a Krishna Patel, Anupriya Patel's mother, who is a union minister. Union minister Anupriya Patel's mother, Krishna Patel, has now aligned with Akhilesh Yadav. What exactly is happening with the BJP there?
She is not an allied partner, Maria, so we are not bothered what she is doing. It is her own decision which way she has to go. Her daughter's political party, she is an allied partner with us. She is in NDA. So definitely we are going ahead in the elections together. But the thing is, the way, you know, all these small political parties, they are getting allied with Samajwadi Party. One thing is clear, like feathers flock together. We know it very well that what is the mindset? The mindset is Jinnawadi. And we believe in Rashtravadita, we believe in Vikaswadita, and they believe in Chinnavadita. So they all are on the same platform. They are Kauravs and we are Pandavs. And we know it very well that who won Mahabharat. So we are going to win. Let them flock together.
So according to you, UP 2022 will be a battle of Mahabharat that will be playing out.
Absolutely. And there is one slogan of Samajwadi Party, Maharaj, ki bais mein bicycle. And I say it, bais mein bicycle ban jayegi tricycle. They will be baby. They're not going to gain anything. They will have lesser seats than 2017.
Okay. Advocate Adil Hassan, you have often faced this charge, not only in this election, but you have faced it in almost all the elections recently, of acting at the behest of the BJP. And that is what Mr. Owaisi is actually carrying, that baggage election after election, including what happened in Bihar, in Bengal as well. In that context, given that kind of nature of the charge that you face, is Mr. Owaisi then open to the idea of aligning with Akhilesh Yadav if it is about consolidating that 20% Muslim vote bank of UP, although it's almost a myth that Muslim vote bank or any community votes on bloc? Then if it is about ensuring that community votes on bloc, shouldn't you be ensuring that there's no division in vote, which should be going to the side which is taking on Yogi Adityanath then? Adil Hassan, You'll have to unmute yourself. You have to unmute yourself. Yes, go ahead. Okay, I'll try and fix that line with Adil Hasan. Let me go back to Saath Sherwani. Saath Sherwani, a quick response to what Anila Singh is saying about your future.
So I would like to ask Anila ji, like I said before, in 2013, 2014, places like Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, all of these places, the BJP got a huge mandate based on similar promises, promises of development, promises of Achhe Din. But what happened in the elections that followed? It's all right to come into power based on a number of ideas and based on, like I said, false ideologies and false promises. She talks about Mahabharat and she talks about how they're going to win. What happened in all of these states? They were shown the door because simply based on false promises, you cannot repeat a government. 5 years they got, 5 years they managed to achieve nothing. Other places like Haryana, places like Karnataka, places like Gujarat, Bihar, they scraped through by the skin of
Adil
their teeth.
Okay, Adil Hasan is back with us. Adil, a quick response and from you on the question that I asked about alliance with Samajwadi Party.
From day one, we told my leader, Barrister Sadhuddin Oasis, I have told that merely my Samikran or any simple Samikran will help BJP. If you want to defeat BJP, the Samikran needs A to Z. We are open to alliance because any single party can't defeat BJP, whether it is Samajwadi or whether it is at any party. We are ready for Gadbandhan. We have to make a grand alliance. Then only you can defeat the BJP. And this time BJP will finish. It is sure BJP is BJP will be less than 100 seats.
Adil Hasan, you are, all of you are just talking in thin air at the moment, because let's not forget that BJP remains very, very formidable as far as UP is concerned. We are seeing that play out on ground as well in terms of optics too. But looking at smaller pockets, when somebody like Sanjay Kumar, who's a sophologist, understands politics much better than several others, is saying that it's a formidable alliance. Why is he saying so? But before that, Pankhuri Pathak, here is Samajwadi Party looking at alliance with all the smaller parties, but is not even looking at the Congress party. You know, despite all the efforts being made by Priyanka Gandhi in saying, count us in, we are also a player, Akhilesh Yadav is not even looking at you while he is looking at forging this grand alliance of like-minded parties. Are you not worried for all the efforts that are being made by Priyanka Gandhi in terms of optics?
The efforts are being made by Priyanka Gandhi ji, those are to strengthen our own party and to fight it solo in the upcoming elections. I don't remember a single time where she has given any sort of indication that she is interested in any sort of alliance. As state president, from the very beginning, he's been asked by a lot of different media channels. He's made it very clear that we'll be going it solo. We have been saying it since the last 2 years. So nowhere have we shown any interest in coming in becoming part of any alliance. And I think we have all seen different alliances playing out in different elections. We too were a part of the alliance last time with the Samajwadi Party. The Samajwadi Party and the BSP, both having their own formidable caste-based vote banks, they came together and we saw the results. So somewhere we have understood that alliances are not a sure-shot formula for anything.
Yeah. Alliances may not be a sure-shot formula, but the fact that there is somebody who is trying to look at these numbers, the BJP is doing the same as well. Sanjay Kumar, why are you saying it's formidable? Because I'm looking at the vote percentage of 2017. The BSP got more than the Samajwadi Party at 22.23%. And the Congress got 6.25, and of course, because it was UP ke ladke, SP and Congress coming together, so they were around 28%. Still, Akhilesh Yadav has chosen not to look at them. Is it because of contradictions that exist here? And it would be safer to align with smaller parties then?
No, Maria, as I said, a possible alliance of Samajwadi Party, BSP and Congress would have resulted in a counter-polarization of voters. And many voters would have sided with BJP. But the effort which Samajwadi Party is making, and why I say it is a formidable alliance, because An alliance of this kind would consolidate the Yadavs, the Muslims, the Jats, also the lower OBC. And look at the geographical spread. While Muslims are, you know, like generally spread all over the UP, but in Western UP and Eastern UP, there is a concentration of Muslim population. Look at the Jat population, the Western constituencies of Western UP. So they Jats are going to consolidate behind this alliance if this alliance is worked out. The lower OBC with the alliance of, you know, Rajbhar and the Anupriya Patel's mother's party. So that will help this alliance in consolidating both around, say, Lucknow, Kanpur, Allahabad region. And let's not forget Aam Aadmi Party, even if Aam Aadmi Party has not contested an election, but we know that generally they have a sympathy support base among the urban sections, urban voters. So that is also going to be cornered by this alliance. That is the reason why I say if this alliance is worked out perfectly, then it is going to be a very formidable alliance.
Okay. Saad Sherwani, the RLD has been on a decline since 2014. Both Jayant and his late father, Jeet Singh, lost from Mathura and Baghpat. In 2017 UP elections, they won just one seat. 2019 parliamentary elections also, they did not get a single seat. What are these parties really bringing on the table for Akhilesh Yadav?
So you can't compare what happened in 2017 to what's going to happen in 2022. 5 years have passed. In five years, we are well aware of what the BJP had promised and what the BJP has delivered. So it's a question of a different mood now amongst the people on the ground. It's a question of each smaller party having its individual pockets of strength and coming together with the larger party, most dominant opposition party in Uttar Pradesh, which is the Samajwadi Party, to show the BJP the door. So it is not, comparing what happened 5 years ago would not be an accurate measure. Comparing the vote share, etc., would not be an accurate measure because we have what's happening on the ground.
As journalists,
today.
We look and at what this, happened in the past. RLD, that is the way you compare future. Or predict future. Fair enough,
Maria. But again, Maria, like I said, what happened in Rajasthan in 13 did not happen in 18. What happened in MP, what happened in Chhattisgarh, what happened in Jharkhand, every place where the BJP got a mandate, they were shown the door 5 years later. Okay. Because you can come to power with false promises,
Anila Singh?
But you cannot repeat if you don't deliver. And they've
Anila
not delivered.
Singh? Anila Singh, if you can hear me.
Yeah, Madam.
So you heard from Saad Sherwani. Here is Sanjay Kumar also saying that this could very well be a formidable alliance, perhaps a better one than what Akhilesh Yadav attempted in 2017 and 2019.
See, what Saad Sherwani just said, it is just a wishful thinking. It is just a wishful thinking, nothing more than that. I heard Sanjayji also. Sanjayji is a very good sociologist, he's a very good analyst. And just now when he mentioned about Apna Dal, K. Krishna Patel's. She said Anupriya Patel's mother's political party. So you can very well understand that what type of political impact can Krishna Patel's Apna Dal can make in the Purvanchal. So, and if I talk about Western Uttar Pradesh, especially if I talk about Jats here, I come from this part of the Uttar Pradesh, Western Uttar Pradesh, and I understand it in and out, and especially the community. If you talk about the Jat community, see, if we see 2014, am I audible, Maya?
Yes, please, loud and clear. Go ahead.
Because, you know, some sort of disturbance I could hear. So in 2014, in 2017, in 2019, we have seen that how Jats have voted for Bharatiya Janata Party. Almost 90% of Jat votes went to Bharatiya Janata Party. And in today's date, if you say that RLD, because of RLD, like RLD is going to go towards Samajwadi Party, Jat vote is going to move towards Samajwadi Party. I think any person, any political party who is doing this analysis is not going to be proven right.
Okay.
Because I will tell you.
Okay.
I will tell you.
Yes.
All right. Still, Jats have not forgotten the deep wounds which they got in 2013 because of Samajwadi Party and Congress. And we have seen that when RLD went with Congress, how Jats, they rejected them.
Yes.
And now,
you know, despite all the narrative, I agree with you, Anila Singh, Jats have voted for the BJP in 2014. They voted for the BJP in 2017 and also voted for the BJP in 2019, despite all the contradictions emerging, which were seen as largely optics, nothing really translated into votes per se. 30 seconds both to Pankhuri Pathak and Adil Hasan. I'm going to begin with you, Pankhuri. You know, for all the talks, UP ke ladke experiment failed miserably, and that is the reason why Akhilesh Yadav is not even keen on engaging with the Congress party. Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, who was there on ground, is again has left UP again. My question is, if you enter a state such as vast as UP, which is full of caste dynamics, what will the Congress what should the Congress really do? At the moment, it is appearing to be just a vote katwa.
Maria, I think you're not updated with the fact. Priyanka ji is on the ground. She's probably the only leader out there fighting. She went to Lakhimpur. She's taking up all the issues that any opposition leader should be addressing. And what we have realized, because in the last 3 decades, we have constantly lost our vote bank, and we have realized that we need to strengthen our own party and alliances. With every alliance, we become weak. With every alliance, we lose our grassroots workers, we lose our voters. This time, we have a face. Earlier, we had a challenge. We did not have a face in the state. Today, Priyanka ji is there, and she is a face.
But she is not a chief ministerial face. She is just general secretary in charge of UPU's campaigning.
She's the one who's on the ground. We cannot announce right away who's going to be the chief minister or not, but she is the face of the party. She is everywhere. Whenever there is a problem in the state, whenever somebody is facing any sort of a harassment or any sort of intimidation from the government, she's right
okay,
there.
Okay, Adil Hasan. 30 seconds to you, and then the final words to Sanjay Kumar. Quickly, Adil Hasan.
Yes, ma'am. Question?
आपका रोल क्या है वहां पर
रोल वी वांट वॉइस उत्तर प्रदेश के असेंबली में भी आवाज हो जो मुसलमानों के साथ जो नाइंसाफी हुई है योगी आदित्यनाथ की सरकार में या अखिलेश जी ने के वक्त से लेकर कभी भी मुसलमान को लगता है कि कोई उसका लीडर नहीं है आपने देखा आज आजम खान कहां है आप देख रहे हैं आज सिर्फ एक कम्युनिटी बेस्ड कास्ट जिस तरीके से भड़काया जा रहा है जिस तरीके से नफरत को बढ़ाया जा रहा है जो मुसलमानों की एक आवाज रहे उत्तर प्रदेश की असेंबली में आज बिहार में है 5 MLA MIM जीता आज महाराष्ट्र के असेंबली में आज तेलंगाना के असेंबली में हमारी भी यही मंशा है कि हम गाजियाबाद से गाजीपुर तक मुसलमानों की एक इंडिपेंडेंट वॉइस रहे ताकि उसकी जो परेशानियां है उसकी जो जरूरतें उसकी जो आवाज है वो उत्तर प्रदेश के असेंबली में जाए
okay. और उसके संजय कुमार द फाइनल वर्ड्स टू यू कैन दिस महागठबंधन एक्सपेरिमेंट वर्क और इज इट टू सून टू से दैट इट विल वर्क
It is too soon to say it will work, but I think if this alliance is formed up, at least we are heading for, the UP election is heading for a close contest between BJP on one side and Samajwadi Party Gathbandhan on the other side. At least this is what I can see this election heading for.
All right, Sanjay Kumar, always a pleasure to have you on my shows. Thank you so much for joining us. Adil Hasan, Sath Sherwani, Pankhuri Pathak and Anila Singh. The discussion shall be continuing on news18.com. That's all for me. Thanks so much for watching.